A record-breaking spaceflight for the Crew-1 mission, swearing in NASA's new administrator, and the anniversary of the first American in space. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. After departing the International Space Station on May 1st, the SpaceX Resilience Crew Dragon spacecraft safely re-entered the atmosphere in the pre-dawn hours of May 2nd and slowly descended back to Earth with the astronauts of our SpaceX Crew-1 mission.
Even though it's nighttime, we have some great visuals of Dragon there with its four main chutes deployed.
The spacecraft and its crew safely splashed down at 2:56 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time off the coast of Panama City, Florida, wrapping up a 168-day mission, a new record for an American long-duration crewed spacecraft mission.
I think everything went like clockwork. In fact, I'm not aware of any objectives that weren't accomplished for our mission. And so on behalf of Crew-1, we want to thank all of the organizations and companies and personnel that contributed to this mission.
Crew-1 also was the first night splashdown of a U.S. crewed spacecraft since Apollo 8's pre-dawn return in the Pacific Ocean on December 27, 1968.
I, Bill Nelson,
do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
Senator Bill Nelson took office as the 14th administrator of NASA on May 3rd after being sworn in by Vice President Kamala Harris during a ceremony at the Eisenhower Executive Office Building in Washington. The U.S. Senate confirmed Nelson to serve as the NASA administrator April 29th. He has an extensive history of working with NASA and has been integral to the agency's current successes. He is looking forward to seeing continued success for the NASA family in the future.
Not only are we going back to the moon and then on to Mars, but look at the scientific achievement that we're going to do. And along the line, inspire a whole new generation of students in science and technology and engineering and mathematics.
May 5th marked the 60th anniversary of NASA astronaut Alan Shepard's historic flight aboard the Freedom 7 spacecraft, making him the first American to travel into space. The flight, which launched aboard a Redstone rocket from Cape Canaveral, lasted just over 15 minutes and demonstrated that a human being could work and survive in space using American-built technology. NASA and Boeing are targeting 2:53 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, Friday, July 30th, for the launch of the company's Starliner Uncrewed Orbital Flight Test 2 to the International Space Station. A July 30th launch would lead to rendezvous and docking with the space station on the evening of July 31st. Our commercial crew program is working with industry through a public-private partnership to provide safe, reliable, and cost-effective transportation to and from the station, which serves as humanity's springboard to space exploration, including future missions to the moon and eventually to Mars. High-voltage functional ground testing with NASA's first all-electric X-plane, the X57 Maxwell, is underway at our Armstrong Flight Research Center in Southern California. The X57 is currently in its first configuration as an electric aircraft called Mod 2. The developmental plane will eventually perform flights to help develop certification standards for emerging electric aircraft. NASA is also supporting these new electric aircraft by developing quiet, efficient, reliable technology these vehicles will need in routine use. During a brief swing by the planet Venus, our Parker Solar Probe detected a natural radio signal. Data from the past, which were translated to sound using data sonification, revealed that the spacecraft had actually flown through the planet's upper atmosphere, making it the first direct measurement of the Venusian atmosphere in nearly 30 years. The Parker Solar Probe mission makes a series of close flybys of Venus that are designed to leverage the planet's gravity to help the spacecraft get closer and closer to the sun. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.